Hello there. Welcome to the WCAG Documents project focused on web accessibility. My name is Yegor. I work as front-end developer here at ACTUM Digital, and I will walk you through this part. In this video, I will talk about the WCAG criterion 1-3-2 meaningful sequence. You can also read it online at accessibility.actumdigital.com, where you will find more information. Let's get into it. The intent of the success criterion is that the correct reading sequence can be programmatically determined when the order matters for understanding the content. Who benefits from it? Users of assistive technologies can understand the meaning of the content that is presented to them in a correct logical sequence. People who copy-paste content like tables or text columns into text editors can preserve the correct formatting and structure thanks to the meaningful sequence. Meaningful sequence means that the content on a web page is arranged in a way that makes sense and easy to understand. It's like reading a book from start to finish. You expect the chapters to be in a certain order, so the story makes sense. Similarly, on a web page, text, images, and other elements should be organized logically so that everyone, including assistive technology, users can easily follow along. Meaningful sequence matters if the content requires order to make sense. The correct order of the content must be clear for all users. If the content does not follow a meaningful sequence, it can be confusing for users. This is especially true for those using assistive technology that reads out the content or when the look of the web page is changed through different styles or formats. I would like to give you a few tips. Avoid using CSS to change the visual order of content in a way that does not match the DOM order, especially when the content inside contains focusable elements. When user navigate a web page using a keyboard, the focus order follows the DOM structure, not the visual layout. If you have used CSS to rearrange the visual order, for example, with flag box order or grid layout styling, keyboard users may experience a confusing or logical tabbing sequence. Avoid using tab index with other values than 0 or minus 1 to force a tab order. Using positive numbers for tab index not only disrupts the natural keyboard navigation, but also makes those elements the first focusable items on the web page, leading to an out-of-order tab flow. This becomes especially problematic when dynamic content is added, as new elements would also need specific tab index values to maintain the intended tab order, making the user experience confusing and maintains cumbersome. Ensure the meaningful sequence is preserved when the CSS is turned off. It guarantees that the content remains logically organized and accessible even without visual styling. Write HTML first, then style it with CSS. This ensures that the content structure is logical and accessible before any visual design elements are added. Let's take a look at some examples. The following example shows us the correct usage or implementation of accessibility. Letter spacing. A heading is formatted to have an increased spacing between letters. Instead of inserting white spaces between characters of the heading, CSS is used to achieve this. This does not disrupt the meaning of the content when the presentation changes. The following example shows the incorrect usage or implementation of accessibility, letter spaces. A heading is visually formatted to have an increased spacing between letters by inserting a white space between the characters of the heading. This type of formatting disrupts the meaningful sequence and readability of the text, making it less accessible and potentially confusing for both assistive technologies and typical users. Use CSS to adjust letter spacing. And that was all about this video. Thank you for watching and see you at the next one. Have a nice day.